Well, good day. And what we are demonstrating in this ACC conference is the conceptual development associated with the stability islands of multiple time delay structures in the time delay domain. Now, this inverted pendulum exercise by Quenzer has been in display for many, many years. And we take this dynamics, this nonlinear dynamics, which happens to be linearized in the equilibrium point. And then we contaminate the feedback line with multiple time delays. One delay associated with the x-directional measurement, and the other delay is the pendulum angle measurement. And then rationally independent delay compositions are coming in the feedback loop, and of course contaminating the performance. Now we want to achieve a certain analytical structure that tells us which composition of time delays would render stable operating performance and which wouldn't. And the cluster treatment of characteristic roots is the paradigm. You can call it CUTCR for the simplicity in remembering. That's CTCR, the cluster treatment of characteristic roots. We utilize very effectively to crack this down. And we have a number of publications on this, not only in the trajectory tracking mode, but also the equilibrium stabilization perspective. But what I would like to tell you is more interesting aspect of the cluster treatment of characteristic roots paradigm, in the sense that the industrial applications are within reach. Number one application is directly in the machine tool industry, where the natural injection of time delay appears. Multiplicity of time delay especially comes into the picture in high-speed milling with variable pitch tools, variable pitch cutters. On this, University of Connecticut, in my laboratory, we just had a US patent issued at the end of 2011, which indicates analytically we can describe what operating conditions, the spindle speed, feedback, feeding speeds, the depth of cuts we can introduce so that the chatter will not occur on the machine tool. This is one very, very strong implementation of the CUTCR paradigm. And the second is a very recent patent filing that has to do with the prediction of Rayleigh instability in jet engines and combustors. So if this paradigm is effectively utilized, we could possibly reduce jet engine weight starting from the combustor design to the housing and then peripherals by 25-30%, hopefully within 10 years. And that is a very, very ambitious direction, but a direct footprint and implications of the paradigm that is in the works in the past, that has been in the works in the past 10 years or so, in the laboratories of the University of Connecticut. We would be more than happy to share the details if anybody is interested, but the practical applications are broad and they are sprouting out very, very effectively.